The Charles Darwin book is called What Darwin Saw, The Journey That Changed the World. And so I'll talk about that one first because it's the most recent of the two. And Charles Darwin, when he was a young guy, in his 20s, he started when he was 22, he took a 5-year voyage all the way around the world. And he was the naturalist on a ship that was actually doing surveying and a lot of other things, and so the trip ended up taking much longer than they thought. And Darwin was wonderful because he was young. He was an age that kids would really relate to him. He was a good-looking guy, very athletic at the time, and he would go anywhere and do anything. He did get seasick on the boat, but other than that, he was just fine, and I loved him because he wrote a series of journals, or he wrote a journal, basically, about the entire trip and told what he did every day. And so, as I went through that journal, which is fascinating, I kind of focused on the science part of it. He had a lot of adventures along the way, but I focused on the science because I wanted to know what it was that influenced him and made him even think about evolution in the first place. And if you read the book, there are clues, big clues, huge clues, on every page as to what he saw to let you know how he came up with that theory of evolution. And then, he didn't even think about it specifically during the trip, but when he came back, he put everything together and he went, aha! And so, the aha moments in the science experiments that he did and all the things that he had learned are shown visibly in the book, and he and I narrate his story. So he tells his part of it through quotes, exact quotes from his letters and journals and books that he wrote, and sometimes he wrote updated versions of his books as he went along and got more sophisticated with what he did. And the thing that made that fun is because he's so likable and he had such a good sense of humor. You can hear his British accent even when you're reading what he wrote, and he's just enormously readable, so readable that everything that he wrote is still in print and has never been out of print to this day. His books were bestsellers during their time, even though he was terrified that his theory was going to turn everybody off because people had such a literal idea about the Bible at the time. And he was terrified that everybody would just hate him. And some people still give him trouble.